When Tom Saintfiet departs Trinidad and Tobago tomorrow, he will leave with a stint to rival Sam Allardyce's one match in charge of England last year in terms of how brief that stint was. He will also leave with one major regret, and that is that he did not stand up for himself when he was first introduced as head coach roughly 1 month ago.
He came highly recommended as well. He worked in difficult situations in Africa, and we feel that he can do the job for us. I will also tell you this, that if he doesn't get the job done on the 24th and 28th of March, he'll be looking for a job. And I make no apologies to say that. He's laughing, but we're very serious. Because if we don't get a result on the 24th and on the 28th of March, we might as well kiss our campaign goodbye.
In one of the final interviews the coach will give on local soil, he spoke of regret and disappointment of not defending himself when David John Williams hired and fired him in one breath in the full glare of the Trinidad and Tobago public. He says if he could do it all over again, he would have stood up for himself or even refused to accept the job.
From the moment of the presentation, things went already wrong. I think that the players and outside world didn't take or respected me like I deserve to be respected, only with the words who were used at the presentation. There is no coach in the world who get presented to the media as new coach and get already fired in the same day. My family told me it was the wisest decision would be to step up that same day. I did not do it because I was happy and proud to be here, and I thought I could achieve something. But after this short period of time, for me it was very clear that I could not achieve anything in this environment.
Saintfiet stated categorically that there was no rift with players, especially Jovan Jones and Kevin Molino. While another of his regrets was the manner in which he handled the situation involving Jomal Williams and Daniil Cyrus, both of whom he accused of reporting to camp smelling of alcohol. Even with just about 34 days in the job, he mentions among his accomplishments being able to expose several local players. He says he'll take some time away from the game to recollect himself, even implying that he might be following the fortunes of the Red Army.
The person who comes now will have first of all 2.5 months time to prepare the team. I had 1 week time to make my first selection, so the new person, he has much more time to prepare his team, plus the dates in March will be official FIFA dates, so all the players who play in United States and in Europe will be available, and also the European based players will be top fit. We have top players, and Trinidad and Tobago has the potential to qualify for World Cup. I believe they're still going to do that, but then you need 90% of your top players available, and then you can add a few others to compensate it, but you cannot have 10% available and the rest compensation. That's not possible.
Well, on the matter, former Trinidad and Tobago defender Brent Sancho is not surprised by the events of the day and says Saintfiet's reign was doomed to fail.
Really gotten the opportunity, probably through fault of himself or outside interferences, to put things into place. That being said, I've said from the very beginning, I think a coach with that sort of resume, that sort of history, would have never gotten us to the goal, which is qualifying to Russia. And I'm not surprised at all that he has resigned from his post. If you look,
TNT goalkeeper John Michael Williams, who never played a single match under Saintfiet, empathized for the Belgians' demise, but says that the FA, players and the country at whole needs to refocus and at the task at hand, qualifying for the 2018 World Cup. However, he's not necessarily convinced that we need to go too far for our next coaching appointment.
There obviously will always be candidates from abroad, but in my personal opinion, and I'm saying this with as much humility as possible, I think we need somebody locally who really knows the ins and outs of the Trinidad players and the culture, and I think that could help us to go to the next level.
been reporting for all of today the resignation of head coach of the national senior men's football team, Tom Saintfiet. Twitter was abuzz with comments from local Trinbagonians, former Trinidad and Tobago players, and of course international football pundits. Most of them poked fun at Saintfiet's short-lived stint in our Twill Island Republic, with former national goalkeeper Shaka Hislop jokingly tweeting, "He's had longer hangovers than Saintfiet's days as head coach." Another member of the 2006 World Cup squad, Brent Sancho, called TNT football a circus with thrills and acts. And our CNews colleague, Peter Christopher, called for answers regarding the person or process who hired Saintfiet based on his long list of former employers and less than stellar results. The Trinidad and Tobago Football Association, through its technical committee, accepted Saintfiet's resignation letter and has advised that a replacement for the post of men's senior team head coach will be found in the shortest possible time and an announcement made in due course.